Oh, seems to be working fine this time. Well, fuck my ass. Okay, yeah. No, I was just wondering, is it loud? Is it like crackly or shit like that, or is it actually clear? To San Francisco if we can. As long as it picks up what I say, that's fine, because usually it gets cut off at the start. Turn the game volume down. Game volume's down just a bit now. Yeah, one of the problems I have with this so far now is that this has six gears. You have two different buttons, one to change from 1 to 6 to 7 to 12, and then the other to 13 to 18. Well, it's fine if you do automatic, but not fine if you do manual. Sliding. Ah. I don't do auto kappa, and besides, I'm listening or I'm reading your chat through an IRC instead of Twitch itself. That reminds me, I'm going to close down the Twitch window because it's using my bandwidth. I can't wait, because I'm saving up my money now, and I'm just going to build a fucking gaming computer, because I'm just sick and tired of this fucking shit. Having to play on 720p on a 1080p monitor. No anti-aliasing, a lot. But shit, it's bare minimum graphics. Just have to tab out of the game every time I read the chat. The roads seem the same. Pretty hard to drive. Oh, I remember this road. I had a big crash here. One thing that really fucking kills me is the fact that the actual distance between the front and rear axles on the truck are much longer now, and it's just a longer truck overall. Just fucks up the turning routine I've got going. Read that in a while. If you want, you can send that message to me in a Steam thing that'll pop up over the game for a couple of seconds, so. Speeding is punished differently in this as well. Fucking cop cars come out of nowhere. As soon as you speed, like when you're on the road, once you go far enough over the limit, I have to change the side of the road. Oh yeah. I suppose that's handy, but the cops in this, yeah, they just appear behind you, so it's pretty much like you've got a speed camera everywhere all over the map. Save up for the nice gaming PC, and then I will eventually buy an Oculus because I'm a fucking sucker. Should. In fact, I'll test it out now. Speed up as fast as I can. Which isn't actually very fast. Something I need to work a fix right now. Button to change up to the higher gear set turns off the engine. I have a favorite. I think there's only two in this so far. There's Kenworth and Peterbilt. Driven Kenworths every time so far, and I don't think I like them. I hope Peterbilts are better, but I have yet to come across one. If I want to fucking stop my engine from now on, I just have to stall it. Just let me out. Fuck you, bitch. new job. What are you? But doing what, should I say? It might be. Then again, nothing would really be easier. This fucking shit.
Connected. Channel switched.
You know what to do now. Yeah, I was testing out the speed limit thing. Fuck me, traffic out of nowhere. I'm already on TeamSpeak Nile in the Racing Sims channel. Oh, by the place there.
User joined your channel.
Oh.
Hello?
Oh fuck, I've made a bad mistake here.
You can hear me, can you?
Can ya?
Sorry, I had to mute the stream because I was getting horrendous, you know,
Yeah. On the stream, I just crashed into someone when you joined. That's my turn.
Ha. Jesus, expensive for a vehicle crash. $900?
Yep. And again, I think it was like that in 2 as well.
It was 500, was it not?
Oh. Dumbass always doing the fucking hard parking challenges.
Ha. There seems to be more of a variety of models along the roadside and such.
Oh Christ above. This is gonna be one fucking cunt of a park job.
They seem to have improved at least a little bit.
Yeah. And again, there wasn't really all that much wrong with the Euro Truck 2 that I could think of. It didn't.
But the speed cameras thing needed changing.
They only changed that though because they, like, I don't think speed cameras are a common thing in the States.
They don't have speed cameras in America. It's only Europe that has speed cameras.
Oh, us. Ooh.
I don't think they believe in that sort of thing.
It violates their freedoms.
Yeah. Have you seen that Making a Murderer?
Oh.
The TV show.
Don't have Netflix, you see.
Oh, you should. It's pretty good. Yeah? Ah. You're missing out, James.
What?
I don't think I could survive without it anymore.
Oh well. He lived without Breaking Bad or Game of Thrones or any other of these fucking flavor of the months, and I think I'll do without this one.
I know, I just like documentaries, so I never watched Breaking Bad. And I wasn't that keen on Game of Thrones, so...
Parking is much harder in this.
Yeah, the trucks look like twice as long.
Not only that, they're just...
You know, and they seem wider on the base as well.
Yeah. I had it there! Balls. Ah, there we go. Got it in near enough. Right, what city should I go to now from El Centro?
Have you got your own truck?
No.
Or are you doing the quick jobs?
Yeah.
Go to Las Vegas. I want to see how it actually looks in the game. If it looks well or not.
Don't have anything to Las Vegas. Get fucking shit
LA
money
then
for these jobs. Okay, if you want me to. I can't do LA actually. I've only got to San Diego or two to Barstow. Oh wait, rail export. I like the sound of that.
Go to Barstow.
Yeah, Barstow's on the way to Vegas as well. tell me what kind of vehicle I'm in.
What, say, sir, I'm reading something, I'm flipping between the two.
I'll tell me what fucking model of truck I'm in. Say, my preferred design, which is always there, and it's always a Kenworth, even though I don't want it.
The driving seems a lot more difficult.
Oh yeah, it really is. Basically, the way I took turns in Euro Truck 2 was I went in like way into the corner and then turned at the very last minute so I'd articulate tightly. And wouldn't, like, if I went in to a junction crossing and there's like a guardrail in the middle, if you turn straight away you kind of hit the fucking rail with your truck, or your trailer. But in this, I have to unlearn that tactic.
Are the highways that seem as big as they actually are in America, do they?
I've been on a few motorway type highways with like full proper on-ramps and shit like that, but you only find them near the cities, or in the cities.
Because it's what meant, like, some of them are, what, 8 lanes?
They haven't been to San Francisco yet, that's where I'm eventually going to get to today. Night, should I say. Fucking yuppies in your fucking convertibles. This fucking shifting is kicking my ass.
Because you have to click so many different buttons to change gears now.
Yeah, it used to be great because I used to just have fucking right stick button on the wheel, and that would change me from 1 to 6 to 7 to 12. But now I have to have right stick button and the start button. So right stick brings me from 1 to 7, and then start from 7 to 13.
Me a bit nuts.
Can't wait for the multiplayer to come out because these things seem to be fast.
What, the trucks?
Yeah.
Faster than European ones?
Yeah. Or at least more power.
Well, their engines are a lot bigger, aren't they?
Yeah. I'll just put down all the way now and see how fast I get. 17th. Take that back, actually. It's having a hard time. Fuck my ass. Power's slowing the fuck down coming into towns. What are they like?
You broke up there. I didn't hear a word you said apart from fuck my ass and going into town.
These cars, they always fucking decide to slow right the fuck down in front of me when we're going into a town. These things are harder to break. Maybe I've just got it set up wrong, but they take ages compared to Euro Truck 2.
Do you not have the air retarders on?
I do. Fucking dipshit.
They just don't break well, no.
Oh, they break too fucking... Oh, I thought you meant the traffic. The traffic breaks too much and these things don't break well enough. Recipe for a real fucking good time right there. Hello. Wondering where the sweet spot is. You see, that's another thing that's really jarred me, but it had to happen eventually. I'm so used to driving just the mans. They have the gear indicator. No, we don't. But this is the default channel. We can't change this one. Nigel, would you care to watch me in the Kenworth Hall and Logs? Because we got a trucking convoy.
I would watch it, but like, I mean, the kids are all still up, so the internet's like slow.
It's a slow stream. 1,000 kilobits a second. Even a peasant your internet should work. I'm at 65 now. There's still no sign of any cops. Fuck me, a 90 degree turn in the middle of a road. Not a road, a motorway. Actually, oh Christ. Went into the dirt there. I was gonna say, these things are easier to turn than the European trucks because they are longer. But, I still do my turns that I've pre-memorized. Still fucks me up.
Your sound just went up like a million percent, whatever you did.
It's probably me, you're right, I had to get headphones about me.
I didn't do anything.
I don't know, like, your volume went like through the roof.
Blame Nigel.
Yeah, I've headphones here on now.
Going up a hill, this should be an interesting challenge.
There we go.
Really fucking steep hill. More satisfying than I thought it would be to climb that hill. Good day. Back.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yep.
Yeah.
Headset doing that thing again.
Yeah. Yeah, no, my sound went absolutely nuts and you were like effingly loud for no apparent reason and just you, not Nigel.
Am I better now?
Yeah, it's back to normal, it was on my end.
It's like you're driving in the fucking desert.
I am, this is California and Nevada. Oh my god, I'm pulling out into the fucking active lane of the highway. And fuck these highways. How the...
Did this only just come out?
Yeah, yesterday.
There's no multiplayer for mod or anything yet.
No, but they're working on it. How the fuck are people meant to drive like this? You'd expect roads like this in fucking Delhi, not America. Where you just pull out and you pull across one fucking motorway to get to the lane of the other. Yeah, the cops are the ones who enforce the speeding penalties in this. Because if you drive too fast, bam, fucking sudden cop out of nowhere. Get a speed ticket. Sorry. Christ. Journey fucking hell. I'll tell you what. Yeah, I'm gonna build a new PC, Nigel. And nice things in it, like a GTX 970, or maybe two of them. Oh, just God. Fucking tired of not being able to play things nicely.
They're pretty expensive though, aren't they?
200 and... Actually, no, I might just get one, because they're £200, I've just remembered that.
I was going to say they're about €250 each, aren't they? That's what I was going to say.
Fuck oncoming traffic, I'm past caring now. Right, I made it to Barstow. And a bar stool, haha. Oh my god, Rail Export has a train in it. Can you believe it?
That's why the trucks are so big, they can transport a fucking train.
I hate this fucking game. It used to be nice and easy where you just parked in the one place and that was it, and it was all pretty much the same in every yard, but now they've got three different difficulties of fucking parking to do. On this one,
is
wrong.
There no auto park?
There is, but I'm not a fucking pansy.
You get less XP for auto parking.
Don't get any XP for auto park.
You're not wearing your seatbelt.
Fuck my seatbelt and fuck you too.
It's not law in all states over there to wear the seatbelt, is it? It's only in some of them.
Yeah. Boston. It's really funny because about 10 years ago, none of them were born.
And I
tell you them.
Scared.
Well, the winter came in here. Was it the 90s? I forget when it came in here. But
it must have been mid 90s because I remember being in cars with no middle seatbelt. In the 90s.
No, I do. I remember. I'm just trying to figure out if it might have actually been early
2000s,
actually.
Fuck these parking yards so much. And I've jackknifed. Terrific.
I thought it was later than that, to be honest.
I'm not quite sure it was way later than that.
I gave up.
I think this is wrong.
I need to buy a new fucking headset, it's really annoying me now.
I go to LA, or, oh no, you were looking for Vegas, weren't you?
Yes, good for you.
Yep.
Vegas to Fresno, wherever the fuck Fresno is.
I'm very sure Fresno is probably in California, because all the people, the giant bomb people now are always going on about.
What?
You what?
What were you, oh fuck, what were you saying there about giant bomb people going on about?
Fresno is in California.
I've got my fucking yard exit strategy mastered.
Jesus Christ, I didn't realize this. Now, do you know that if your car doesn't have seatbelts in the back, you won't actually get, like, fined?
Well, because I suppose you can't.
Yeah, but surely you'd be like, oh, you'll have to get them fitted. But no, you don't. You won't get fined, you don't have to end them.
Well, it's not like a light bulb being out or a fucking tax system expired. You don't have to have them, you know?
I'm just reading the legislation. It says the only exemptions to it is if your car was made before 1992 and it doesn't have seatbelts fitted in the back seats, you do not have to wear. You will not be charged with any sort of fine or penalty points.
Though I bet you they'll say something to you and you get yourself in trouble.
Maybe. That's hilarious. I wonder if you got a car old enough that it didn't have a front seat belt.
Yeah, like classic cars. See, we drive them, some loads don't have seat belts. Now I think about it.
Yeah. That's bullshit though. You'd think they just have to force people to fit seat belts and that.
Yeah. They can't, because classic cars fall under like certain legislation that are different.
Mm.
Solved this fucking so many times already.
Ah, but here we go. Your insurance mightn't cover you if you're in a crash and you don't have seatbelts in the back.
What the fuck insurance is that? Health insurance? Oh, well, you weren't wearing your seatbelt, so we can't pay for your spinal reconstruction surgery.
Your facial,
I was going to say more for your car.
We'll fix your car though.
Like, I don't know. Like,
no, it's probably if passenger who's in the unbelted seat that it won't cover their bills.
Maybe, I don't know.
I'm going to try an experiment and start in 7th gear. Holy fuck, it worked. But there goes a whole range of gears that I won't use from now on.
Oh wait, there's an exception here. If a child is under 3 years old and you have them in the back seat without a seatbelt, you'll still be fined.
So basically, sorry Timmy, can't take you to school today because I'm driving my classic car. Fuck you! Although a 3-year-old going to school doesn't make much sense, but okay. I just saw a stretch limo.
Play school.
I suppose. Good save, Nigel, good save. Your classic cars, get the fuck out my way!
I feel like this game has worse graphics than the European one.
No, it's just worse on my end because I have to turn all the settings down, otherwise it just fucking... Is that Nigel or Niall? Okay, yeah, I had to turn all the...
Niall's internet is dodgy.
I had to turn all the settings on this down, otherwise it would be unplayable. That's why I want a new fucking computer, so I can actually experience things in more than 40 frames a second on good settings rather than lowest.
Yeah.
Roads are much fucking bendier in this than in Euro Truck 2. That doesn't help with these long Euro trucks. 80, fuck yes. Finally a highway that isn't 55.
Headset.
What's your headset got to do with you disconnecting?
No, I had to disconnect because my headset keeps failing and then reconnect and you can't hear anything, so you have to unplug it and close everything down that was using the headset.
Right.
Using the mic, like, for some reason it goes nuts. I'm looking for a new gaming headset.
Logitech G930, check them out. Heard good things, apparently.
I like this one, it just calls itself the vibration headset, yeah?
Got two little dildos on each ear cup that also clean your ears if you stick cotton on them.
Well, and if you accidentally drop them, yeah?
Yeah. That's 80 miles an hour in kilometres. 100 and...
20, is it?
No, 72 is 120.
80 miles is 130 kilometers,
so this is actually a truck speed limit that I'm on now, and it's 80, which is faster than the fastest one in all of Euro Truck. So, got that going for it.
Remember, America's like desert regions are basically there's nothing in them, so they. I allow you to go super fast just because.
Just to get the fuck out of there. It's like knock. You want to get out of there as fast as you possibly can.
My mother actually got pulled over in knock once for going too fast. I swear to God.
Sudden speed limit change. Move, you classic bastard.
Jeez, this is a fancy one. Logitech Artemis Spectrum.
Name alone makes me want to kill myself. Yeah,
here's my one. It's only like 50 quid.
You put it on. I'm on the Spectrum. Yes, you are.
I don't know what this says about me, but when I hear Spectrum, I always think of the ZX Spectrum. I don't know if you know what that is.
Some kind of computer, gaming computer.
Yeah. It was like a British thing.
Why does the name Sinclair pop into my head?
I was born in England, Nigel, doesn't mean I know everything British.
I didn't say you'd know.
Fucking racist.
Don't worry, Niall, we know that you don't know anything.
If anything, James is the one who should know, considering he's a game developer.
No. I've heard of a Sinclair Spectrum, is that anything similar?
No.
That's a spectrograph, is it not?
Oh.
But anyway, the ZX Spectrum is some shitty, like, Atari type thing from the 80s.
You make your own games on it, that's why it's ringing a bell. Had an active programming scene for it.
People used to, like, make music with it and shit.
Miles an hour, I fucking envy the man who can get to 70 on these brick of roads.
Uh, Did you see this thing about them getting cancer cells addicted to drugs so that they can kill them?
No.
That's one thing that I'm going to have to do very soon to test out in this game. I'm going to have to do a barrel roll with a truck.
I want to see that.
In fact, I'll do it now. I'll just save first.
Fucking thing keeps going.
Oh, this is going to be funny. I hope.
Niall, why is your internet so bad? You live in England.
Not my internet, it's my fucking headset.
Internet's fine. Right.
Yeah, it's the fucking headset. It's
racing for impact. Holy shit, I went straight up in the air doing that.
This video is significantly behind your voice.
Okay, I'll try it one more time.
The fucking connector is gone on the headset, Nigel, so it just keeps, like,
oh God,
losing connection to everything.
The wheel is having a seizure.
Right, I'm gonna do it. Crash again, but this time in external view. I don't know why, but this reminds me of Fallout, just a bit.
Probably because of the desert.
Oh, have a desert.
It is the same desert, is it not?
I don't know. And where are you? This is Las Vegas.
Yeah, because Mojave is massive, isn't it?
Yeah. Okay, now, just out of interest. Crash test 2. Well, at least I packed it out of the way of the oncoming traffic. You okay in there, big guy? Yeah, he's fine.
Oh God. On stream, you just did it there now, so your voice is about 20 seconds ahead of the stream.
Yeah, it doesn't Twitch totally have like a 20 second latency anyways.
I know, but sometimes it's not that bad. Sometimes it's only like 10.
Okay, let's try this one more time.
Oh,
what are you laughing?
What? The other thing I was saying there about how, you know, UK scientists got cancer cells addicted to drugs that would kill them. One of the top comments is the same thing we did to the black people.
Oh dear.
At least he's honest, Nigel. At least he's honest.
The racist. You're fucking racist.
The good old crack in the ghetto technique.
They are having some good crack, alright. That's what we have in common with them.
Where did these racists come from? This is a serious article about, like, cancer and science and a random racist appears.
Racists are everywhere, no matter level of education.
Plot twist, the person who wrote that comment was the one behind the study.
It's like blacks are a cancer.
The racist was coming from inside the house.
See another fucking Valentine's Day advert, I go mad.
Let's not talk about that.
Get to spend it with John Smith.
Why, what have you got yourself for Valentine's?
I should put up some sort of message on Facebook that I got a job in Aragon, because I want John Smith.
You should, because it would drive John Smith up the wallet.
Yeah, but I don't do that. Like, I'm not one of these people who puts up fucking messages about
Nigel, yeah, but no, you want to.
It seems
but
a
why
lot.
Didn't you pretend you accidentally meant to send a private message to someone and accidentally have it as a post?
Can one of you not just put a message on my thing?
No. I'm not being your tool for annoyance.
He's only your tool for sexual pleasure.
Can you not just be like, what, I heard you got a job or something? Or no? Can you not like put and then John will ask? No.
Good stuff.
I want to see a public bitch fest, and I don't want to get caught in any crossfire.
Alright, I'll do it for you, Nigel. I'll write it like this. Congratulations on the new job in Westport and Allergan, Nigel. Then I'll tag John Smith in it at the end. Subtle? Okay.
Look, just tag the biomeds, you know.
yeah, post it in the group. Oops, sorry, wrong group. How did you even get in this group? Gotta go.
You're not even administrator for that group.
Excellent.
That doesn't seem the safest way to do things.
What's that?
That any member can invite another member.
No, he's an administrator.
No,
that's not very safe.
And I was friendly with, remember?
Woman, that's definitely not safe.
Oh, sick burn.
What? I didn't hear what he said.
What'd
you say,
then? I didn't say anything,
Nigel. I've forgotten what he said, actually.
There was something about a woman.
I said, Nigel getting friendly with a woman.
That was Kira, the nutty one. Do you remember?
Yeah, that's why we said it was dangerous.
They made it funny.
Yeah. She was friendly with me, so she made me an administrator of that group when she set it up, because I was the first person she invited. So I remember I invited like Luke Slaughter to that group there last year, and she went mental. She sent me like a load of angry messages, like, what the hell are you doing? He's not part of our class. I was like, whoa, calm down, man. And Luke was in the room with me when I did it, and he was laughing at all of it.
Tell her Luke had more class than she ever will.
Sure, didn't she have like an emotional reaction when you told her that you like you fancied the whole of her, basically?
Yeah, it was really funny.
She had an allergic reaction to Nigel's affection.
No, it's like, I don't want any more. See, that was the thing. But then, like, on one of the last days of college, I was like, oh, yeah, I really did. And she's like, oh, yeah, yeah. It was really funny.
If only you said something.
Yeah, she's like, oh, I wish you had told me earlier. I had a great laugh.
Oh, I know the smell of smoke off her, but she didn't need chloroform. The fucking smell of smoke could knock you out.
I know, yeah. I think she stopped smoking though, I think. I don't know.
Is that why she weighs like 5 stone more? Or is that her excuse why she weighs 5 stone more?
Well, that and that she has a boyfriend, so she doesn't need to, she's not on the look for anyone.
I'm here.
And he's kind of like the same weight as her anyway. So.
Hey! I don't care what weight I am, the woman better I'm gonna have a whip whipping her into shape, goddammit.
I remember that one was getting crossed before because I was ended up like almost the same weight as her.
That makes me look bad, yeah?
Yeah, I think that was like something like that.
That's a psychological issue though.
Yeah, because she was giving out. Like really thin.
You should be like, just because you're fatter than me.
That's what I said.
She loved that.
I know, well, it was a joke, because she actually isn't. So, she's still lighter than me.
What? You keep fucking tabs on each other's weight now, do you, Nigel?
No, that was back then, you dork.
I know, I was trying to get a reaction from you. It succeeded.
It's 28 inch quiz.
I'll go nicely with your 2.8-inch, you know what.
good work.
Yes, I thought you'd enjoy that one.
Yeah.
Fuck the red
you
lights.
You made a funnier joke about pie there, but no, you missed the opportunity.
No, that's not James's type of material.
Mathematics is not science, Joe.
I just broke red lights and there's a cop right there.
Kill the police, man. It's your only option.
It'd be good if you could, like, gun them down.
Oh god, you're gonna get.
Where the fuck can I buy a headset? Maplin's.
Amazon.
You live in England now, so Amazon can do like overnight delivery to you.
Don't buy their fucking alcohol over there. They can come and send someone and fucking massage you. Basically, they will do anything for you. Not us, because fuck us, we live in Ireland. It's just against the law.
Second class. We're just filthy plebs.
Especially you.
Yes, especially me. Will you actually do that, Jez, or something? Just put a congratulations on getting the job in Westport at, or whatever, just at some point.
I suppose. It's just silly, though.
Don't fucking tag John Smith.
I won't. Dad, you fucking Killjoy. I'll write the comment saying congratulations on the job, and then Niall can come in and say, oh, John Smith, you've got a friend.
Oh, gosh. I'll be like, John, how come you didn't get that job in Westport?
Yes? Oh, God. Has the added bonus of making Melissa salty as well, because she applied for it too, I think.
Yeah, she applied to the microbiology department, I think.
Yeah, isn't that where you're working, the microbiology department?
Yeah, that's my job, I'm a microbiologist.
That's my job, I just went quiet there!
My job, you know what's going to be funny is that most of my classmates are going to be so pissed off because I didn't even pass the board to the exam.
Sure, it doesn't that make that much of a difference if you know someone.
No, but see, they're like, fucking lies, you bollocks, he doesn't even like science.
Sure, they were like that while you're in class with them as well, so nothing's changed there.
They'd all be mad. I can just imagine them being like, he doesn't deserve it.
They don't exactly deserve it either, to be honest, no.
They passed their exam, we didn't.
They're sitting in they went to Sligo, they're dust, they don't deserve anything, that's live land.
Of course. Yeah.
Taking significantly longer than I thought it would.
But this drive seems to be a fuck ton longer in that game than they are in the,
In terms of length?
In the, what you call that?
Like, America's a bigger...
No, it's not, they're actually smaller than Eurotruck. Eurotruck, I used to take fucking jobs from Hungary to the UK. For shits and giggles. And now... Oh, there we go. I was about to fucking abandon that and just let me do it there.
The next glorious mod should be to somehow combine both of the games together.
Would be nice. Yes.
You have to get a plane and it just happens to land you in Europe, yeah?
The aircraft carrier massive York or something.
If I can't find fucking just... San Francisco now, because it's starting to piss me off.
There we go. Excellent version. Excellent.
Well, you just drop the cargo off, say, at an airport, then you, like, load, and it's a different truck. Things up in Europe.
Yeah, you go to the fucking ports now, you drop it off, and then you get in the container with the fucking goods, and then get out and drive a different truck.
Fucking wanking thing.
Right, let's find this fucking... Canton Bay area, hotbed of Peterbilt. Hotbed of shitty
USB connection. Why the fuck does it keep giving me ones of stereo jack connections?
Fuck oncoming traffic that isn't me.
I'd get this one if it wasn't such a hideous colour.
Sure, mate. Send it.
It's fucking hideous. It's like your shoes, Nigel.
What shoes?
You'll see.
My shoes are... Which pair of shoes of mine are hideous?
I think I just saw a neon sign that said Cock City.
Yep, sounds like that.
Look for it, it's on the right and it's flashing purple.
Isn't that a foul colour?
Yeah. Like, maybe they don't look that bad in real life, I don't know.
That's a freeway.
Pretty fucking bad there.
Why is this in Mexican or something?
Wouldn't it be Spanish, Nigel, not Mexican?
You're in Mexico, dog! Speak Mexican!
Nigel, no racist!
I'm not a racist.
What the fuck is wrong with the gears on this thing? It only has 10 gears. Well, fuck my ass.
I'm downloading XCOM at the moment.
The new one?
Yes.
Didn't realize that was coming out.
Before
like
you say,
this.
Go on a big long spiel about it. I don't really care about XCOM.
Fuck you.
No, no, I was just saying I'm downloading it at the moment. It's fucking massive.
How big?
26.
Fuck that.
Well, it's just a next gen game, inverted commas. So, I mean, they're all reasonably big.
Glad I got this instead, yeah. Because it was only 20 euro as opposed to 50 for that, and it was only 1 gig instead of 20 whatever.
I only paid 30 for XCOM, 30 euros.
You bought it on some other website.
Yeah, get what you call it, Green Man.
Game. Yeah.
But I bought it last month when it was on like 50% off or something ridiculous.
Yeah.
Where the fuck is Maplin selling laptops? They're only meant to sell parts, the bastards.
Nigel, you've got your finger on the pulse of the gaming world. Any news on when the HTC Vive is coming out?
I haven't really heard anything that much about that. Doesn't everyone think that one's kind of like going to be like super expensive compared to all the other ones?
Well, the Oculus is the super expensive one, unfortunately.
No. I mean, people are saying the HTC Vive would be even more expensive.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, they're saying
the
like, it would be like $800 or $900 or something. I don't know.
What sort of crazy person's gonna pay that?
And the Vive, doesn't the Vive has like motion controls or some bollocks, isn't it? It has like some weird motion shit.
I think so. I think I've seen it in action. Not sure if it is the Vive or not.
Like, it would definitely be more expensive. If anything, the cheapest one would probably be that one that Sony's making, but I think that's just for the PS4, I'm not sure.
That's a bit mad, in fairness. It wants to pay $700. Something like that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'd love to get one, but there's no way I'm paying that much money for it. They can fuck off.
Gears on this thing. Distance in between them is fucked. There's more on the Kenworth than in Euro Truck Trucks, and there's less than Euro Truck Trucks on the Peterbilt, or this particular one. That's just fucked my entire rhythm up, you know what I'm saying?
But James, do you get rhythm when you have the blues?
What the fuck are you on about? Oh my god, an actual toll booth. I thought I had left these behind in Europe. Fuck me.
Sorry, James, just interrupt you. Apparently the Vive is out in April.
Any words on the price? Also, what's the source on that?
There was something happened, like, today. There was some sort of event. Polygon is where I'm reading it.
Reputable, but fuck him anyways.
The Vive will target the high-end consumer. That's all they've said in relation to the price. So it's going to be very expensive.
Bastards.
It's like $2,000 now, I think. Ridiculous, yeah?
Yeah. I'll be back in a sec.
Nigel, did you buy yourself some fancy shoes for this, yeah?
No, that was a joke. I was naturally serious.
I won't be surprised.
No, because I sent them to you because I thought they were kind of funny looking, so I thought you'd say something funny. I sent them to Owen. Owen's response is actually kind of funny. Owen's like, he said they're not appropriate for the lab. He said if you spilled an acid on them, it would eat right through them.
What fucking Owen know about working in a lab?
I don't know, I just thought it was funny that was his immediate reaction. So, he didn't say they were stupid or whatever. He said they're not appropriate for the lab. He said that
what fucking sort of shoes does he think you're wearing? Any shoes, if you spill acid on them, are going to be eaten through.
Yep. No, didn't they give Kevin some sort of like steel-toe things to wear?
That's only because forklifts are operating in the area.
All right.
That's nothing to do with chemicals. Sure, drop a load of chemicals on shit, it's not gonna.
Pretty sure acid can eat through steel.
That's what I mean. Like, so steel-capped shoes wouldn't make any fucking difference. Yeah.
If anything, it would be more nuisance because it'd be hard to get them off.
Yeah, you're more likely to lose a toe.
Yeah. If anything, you probably want something loose that you can immediately pull off your foot.
Well, not loose, because then stuff can slip down the back of it.
Pause.
But like, regular fitting shoes. Like, Charlie doesn't have a fucking clue what he's on about. He's never actually worked in a lab.
Pause here.
He's worked, like... He's worked in bloody...
Semi-production environments.
Production environments, which are different to labs.
Yeah. It's quite ironic, in a way, that I'll be the one who ends up with more lab experience.
Yes. Yeah, but Owen doesn't want fucking lab experience. If he actually went and applied, I've seen a shit ton of jobs today. That you could
depending
actually
on
apply
if you
for.
Get a job in science or not, by the end of my time with Halligan, I can end up having more experience than you in science as well, which is also hilarious.
Yes. But I'll end up with more money, so I
probably.
Know which, well,
I'd rather be in the money position.
Yes, I prefer the money position too. I technically have 2 years in the lab, Nigel.
I don't. What you were doing in Trinity wasn't lab work. Was
it technically is. It's dry lab and wet lab work.
You tell that to industry and see what they say.
Actually, what I did, because we developed SOPs for industry, so... some of it would be classed as par.
They will look their noses down upon you.
A lot of them don't. It depends, like, if you did actual lab work in research, and if you did, like, pretending to do lab work in research, they're two different things.
Pretending, that sounds good, I like that. How do I do that? How do I get paid to pretend to do lab work?
Well, Nigel, you go work in some place, like, what's that place you worked in before?
Charles River.
Yeah, that place.
I don't know, they work there. They're just kind of like, they're a bit haphazard. They do work. I imagine I'll have to work an awful lot harder here in Aragon, considering it's an MNC.
So. You probably will. It's owned by, whatchamacallit, isn't it? Pfizer's.
Pfizer is the owner, and they're quite altogether. So. But even if they weren't owned by Pfizer, they are a multinational company, so things are strict, I would imagine.
Yeah, Pfizer though had an extra level of strictness.
I'd say they have zero influence at all on the company culture.
No, Pfizer are a bit arsehole-y about stuff like that. They're like very hands-on approach.
Hmm. Also, my contract makes no mention of 12-hour shifts.
Yeah, they'd have to give you a new contract for that.
All right. So I mustn't be coming in yet, because they said in the interview back in December, they told me microbiology doesn't have a 12-hour shift, but they said it would be coming in.
Yes, it must at the end of that contract.
That contract is... I don't know. It's kind of annoying how they don't tell me how long the contract is for.
Is it a rolling contract then? That's apparently
fine. It just says it's a fixed term contract.
Oh, that's the worst, because you don't actually know.
Yep, it's a bit of a nuisance, but at the end of the day, I don't really give a shit. So, because I'd probably just leave anyway, so. I don't know. It was a very weird contract, in my opinion, when I read through the whole thing. It's kind of strange. And, you know, technically I don't work for Adelaide.
Work for an agency.
Yeah, I work for CPL.
Yeah, that means you have no rights.
Yeah, I know, yeah. I already knew that going into science jobs, I know that's like...
Okay.
Well, although everything is kind of like that now as well, because I know talking even to my accounting friends, they're not even getting full-time positions, which is absurd, unheard of.
They're being taken on. It's cheaper for them to run everything through agencies these days.
Yeah, it's ridiculous. That my accountants are being taken on through agencies and being kept.
Yeah, you have to be there for like 7 or 8 years before they even bother to go like, oh, now we'll actually take you on permanently.
I'm back.
Some politician would just want to... pushed to update legislation with regards to employment. Get it to cover contract work.
Yes. The employment law here is worse than it is in Ireland when it comes to agency work.
It's worse than England?
Yeah.
Why? How could it be worse?
Because you have to sign away, even though legally, you know, you don't have to, but you basically have to sign away your work rights.
Well, such as what?
To get a fucking job.
Such as what, though? Because, like, you basically maximum, have no rights here anyway.
Maximum working week.
Oh, right.
You sign that away, then you have to sign your minimum wage away if you take a really shit job. That's insane.
Yeah.
Like, that is fucking insane.
They wouldn't do that here.
It's going on, Nigel. It is going on there.
I don't know.
You just don't see it because you haven't applied for, like, some really shitty jobs with an agency. You know what I mean?
I can't imagine a science job would pay below minimum wage.
No, but I'm saying about is if you went for, like, a job, say you didn't have...
Run into San Francisco now.
Even Coca-Cola told William how long his contract was. They told him that they'd keep him until July and then he's gone.
Ha! Lots of that temporarily because they like to recycle employees because it's cheaper to get a new one, apparently.
Yeah.
For an untraining job.
Nearly flipped the truck by accident that time. Where the fuck, if Lombard Street's in this and I have to go through it for a delivery, I'm gonna flip my shit and just punch the screen. Know which street I'm on about?
Nope.
Look it up. You'll know it when you see it. In San Francisco.
I was thinking, you know, John Smith is probably on more money than me working in a nightclub.
Night money is more, isn't it?
Well, I have to work nights occasionally.
Yeah, but if he's always on nights, he'd always be on more. Yeah, but you're going to get more hours, because he's not working there every night of the week.
It might be though, I don't know.
There's no way that nightclub there is going to get enough revenue.
It's Westport.
Yeah, but Westport doesn't have a student population.
I suppose.
Doesn't, there's Castle Baron nearby. Everyone. Doesn't need a student population because it...
My brother was saying...
But that's the thing.
There's not that much transport from Castle Bar to Westport, even buses. Like,
but that,
that's bullshit.
That's
like loads of transport from...
All the people feeding in from the fucking surrounding towns with no nightclubs, because you get minibuses, that's for sure.
Yeah.
But you only see like them at night.
My friends from Ballyhonus. Yeah, my friends from Ballyhonus stay to go over to Westport.
It's a long enough trip.
Yep. My brother is to go to Westport. And he lives in now. Kind of just like the happening area or some shit.
Like Galway.
What? No, Galway's way better.
Galway is very happening.
No, but like I was kind of like Westport is kind of just where the boggers all go. As you like to call them.
Sligo's also big for that too.
People don't go from Ballyhonus to Sligo.
Yeah, buses go from fucking Castle Rhee and all them areas.
You wonder about like the fucking prisoners.
No, yeah.
Sick,
night,
sick burn. Fucking hell. That was just out of nowhere. Stone Cold fucking killer Nigel right here.
Savage. Yeah. Damn, it feels good to be a gangster.
Sure does. It sure does.
Yeah. What's Let's Play It Safe? What does that do?
That gives you an easier parking thing. But you still have to park it yourself. Actually, this one is easy. Know what to do. Fortunately, I crashed. No, I didn't crash. Fortunately, I do know what to do, so fuck you, game. Slightly more challenging than I thought it would be. Still completely doable.
Kyle, you don't drive from this here.
I am busy.
You don't know, like my uncle, who's like 35 or, well, no, 40, and he never learned how to drive. I recommend it, Grant Smith.
Harder than it looked. Assuming that's Niall telling me that his headset's broken. Then two messages for yes and one for no. They didn't want that grass all too much, because it's gone now. Dead. off. To hear about that now. For you and your poor microphone. Dynamita. Or Elko. miles an hour, are you fucking kidding me? A fucking stupid speed limit is that? Good gains are being erased. Stupid driving. Look at this plonker. And fuck these traffic lights. that tall. Filtering. Shit, that's fucked the stream. Bollocks.